most people that live in Perry County probably has never been down in a cave. They live on a unique environment. There's a lot of different things going on underneath their very feet. It's got the most caves within the state, and the three longest caves are found here in Perry County.
The caves here were formed over millions of years, born and fed by water that flows from the surface. And in the streams that flow through these caves, people exploring them made a fascinating find. A fish, never before recorded.
So the Grotto Sculpin were first discovered in the early 1990s when cavers that were caving in this area first brought the sculpin to the attention of researchers. It's the only known location for these sculpin. Caves are very unique environments. When you go underground and there's the lack of light, it's a completely different world. The Grotto Sculpin are unique because they're in the transition phase. They're actually evolving and adapting to the cave environment. And that makes it very unique. It's an interesting way to study them, to look at what's going on, and to actually get some detail in terms of the progress and what happens over time.
The starting point for the Grotto Sculpin, from a biological perspective, is the Bandit Sculpin. They reside on the surface nearby.
The Bandit Sculpin live on the bottom of streams. They get their name from the banding pattern on the side of the fish, and they often have very large eyes situated on the top of the head for seeing their prey. Typical Bandit Sculpin have very dark pigmentation and allows them to blend in well into the substrate to avoid getting eaten by other species.
Some of these fish move to caves. Over time, through generations, the sculpin that migrated there started to change to meet the challenges of the underground world they now call home.
They differ from a typical surface banded sculpin. They have reduced pigmentation, reduction in eye size, and enlarged lateral line pores, which allow them to sense their environment without having use of their eyes. As they adapt to the cave environment, we expect that over time we'll see more and more individuals that have smaller eyes, that lack pigmentation, and that show those unique cave adaptations.
With the Grotto Sculpin, these biologists have a rare opportunity in these caves to witness and record the process of biological change as it happens. But for all that transpires underground, it is still the surface that may hold the key to the future of this beautiful and complex environment.
I think one of the most important aspects of cave protection, particularly in a place like Perry County, is just that people are aware of the cave systems, aware that runoff from the surface directly impacts the caves.
So as you go about your life here on the surface, remember that the beauty and wonder of Missouri is more than skin deep. There is a fascinating world, one of incredible sights and unique life, that lies beneath us.